Hi, David.
Hi, hello, Chris. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Fine. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, we'll come, maybe come later. Yeah.
Yep. I hope so. There's nobody here yet.
Nobody here yet?
Nope.
All right. Is it going to snow today?
I don't know. I haven't checked. Have you seen that it's going to snow?
Yeah, I checked like around 10, 11.
Okay.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, there we go. I wonder where everybody is today.
Maybe traffic.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe traffic. Well, we'll give everybody a couple minutes.
Yeah, sure. I like your hat. You're kind of...
Oh, my bandana? Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
All right.
Is Yaya coming today?
She's not decided yet. I don't know.
It's no problem. Oh, here's Herb.
Yeah.
All right. At least we got two of you guys.
Yeah.
Such a weird morning.
Yeah.
Well, we got a bunch of song requests. Oh, here's Nancy.
Nancy's coming too.
There we go. And D, oh, I'm so happy to see everybody. There was just me and David this morning. It was just me and David. We were worried nobody was coming.
And we here.
All right.
Hey, Nance.
Hello.
I actually tried to make yesterday afternoon's class in about 4:15. I have a garbage disposal down here and I threw like some shrimp shells down there and some onions and all of a sudden I hit it and the whole thing started backing up.
Oh God.
I'm like, I don't think I was supposed to do that. So I didn't want to, my husband told me before I throw anything down there, I need to read the list of what not to put down there. So
is shrimp on the list?
I guess shrimp is on the list, a fibrous vegetable. So I think like the skin of the onion. Anyway, the garbage disposal is like.
Well, why were you throwing whole onions down the garbage disposal anyway?
Yeah. So I was like, okay. So I was trying to like fix it before class and I was just like I'm not gonna win anyway. We're getting a new garbage disposal put in tomorrow.
Nice. Nice. I know they make those industrial strength garbage disposals that you could put anything down, so
yeah,
you grab yourself one of those.
I know, my husband's like, you know, I was worrying about when the kids come down and we're not here, they're going to break things. He's like, why bother? You're doing this all on your own. I said, yes, I'm systematically going through and I'm breaking everything that needs to be fixed. So there we go.
That's a good idea. All right, we have a bunch of songs on the list today. The first one we're gonna play is the Rolling Stones, As Tears Go By. Let's see. Let me share the screen.
Whoever, I thank you for sending me the link to the song yesterday.
That was probably Herb.
Yep, Herb, thank you very much.
No problem.
Now you sent me two. Is one any better than the other?
No.
They're both the same.
I wasn't sure about your email address.
Oh, okay. Well, that's my real name. This name that you see on the screen is actually my daughter's, but I answer to D. So that's fine.
Is D not actually your name?
No, it's Diane.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's okay. I answer to D all the time.
Okay. All right. Just that's making sure. I mean, I'd feel bad if we were calling you just some random name for the past several months.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my daughter's.
All right. Is she Diane as well? Or is her name just D?
Actually, her name is Demetra.
Demetra, that's a great name.
Yeah, she's named after her dad. James in Greek is Demetrius. So Demetra is the feminine of Demetrius.
Wow. I wouldn't have known that. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, her dad's Greek, so.
Gotcha. All right, everybody. We've got a Rolling Stones song here. So let's, it's pretty simple chords, C, D, F, G, and A minor. So I'm gonna mute out everybody here. I really can't wait till we could all play together, you know? It's gonna be so much better. I missed the sound of like 20 ukuleles playing at the same time. All right. So the strumming pattern for this one, I believe, is the island strum. Oh no. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up. All I need As tears go by, the Rolling Stones. It's a good band, but I probably would have been a Beatles guy had I have been around when the two were warring. The Rolling Stones, I don't know. I like Mick Jagger. I saw them live once, and I never got to see the Beatles live, obviously. But, man, did the Rolling Stones put on a good show. And they were, like, in their 60s when I saw them, and they were just amazing. The energy that Mick Jagger has and the fact that Keith Richards is still alive after all the drugs he did is pretty amazing. Pretty fascinating to see how that works. I don't know. All right. 16 tons. 134. By Merle Travis. Down, down, up, down, down, up. We're going to skip the intro because I forget how to play it. And we're going to start right with the words. I know a bunch of you are singing the intro right now. I'm sorry. It's my fault. Okay, here we go. One, two, one, two, three. Some people say a man's made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bone. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go out of my soul to the company store. Oh, that's how you do it. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. 16 tons of number 9 coal. A strong boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and a deeper in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I'm my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling and rain. Fighting and trouble on my middle name. I was raising the cane, break my old mama line. Can't know I told a woman, make me walk the line. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Saint Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men did, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, another of steel. If the right don't get you, then the left one will. You know, 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. That's
so important. That is definitely a song that I could practice. I like the song. It's just the chord changes became so fast. It was that G minor. I kept going.
But it's very quick. It's very quick. And as I was playing it, I was sort of trying to slow it down a little bit at a time because I realized when I started playing it how fast the changes were. Sometimes I don't see it at the beginning how quick it's going to be. So I'll try to slow it down a little without ruining the whole experience of the song.
Yeah, I love the what genre is that? Because you were singing it and I was playing and all I kept thinking in my head was Stray Cats, you know, Stray Cats Strut.
Yeah, well, that swing, the Stray Cats Strut, okay, right? That's swing music. But this is, I think, closer to country than swing, you know?
All right.
Because, I mean, Merle Travis, I mean, the other guy who wrote it is literally named Tennessee. So it's probably country.
Yeah, it is. But it's got that, I kept thinking of that song when you were singing it.
Yeah, if you sped this up, you pretty much have swing. It's very, very close to that. If you sped this up and took out all the minor chords, you know, because there's a lot more major stuff going on in swing. Okay. But yeah, this would sound a lot like that. The chords are very, very similar.
Yeah, this is a great song for me to try to master.
Yeah, absolutely. This would be good for a lot of people to get it up to speed. Yeah, and make sure you listen to the original. I'm going to keep harping on that. Listen to the original thing, because that's how you get an idea how the song's actually supposed to sound, you know? And playing along to the original, if it's in the same key, can be very, very helpful, definitely.
All right. The three of those chords are not, I guess, normal.
Well, the G minor doesn't come up a lot. The B flat's a little more normal than you would think. It's in a lot more songs than you would think. And the A seventh is, it's kind of rare too, I guess. But that's an easy one. A seventh is easy.
Oh, yeah, A7, but I was talking about the B
flat and the G minor. Yeah.
G minor. Yeah, I've never done those before, I don't think.
I think you probably did the B flat at some point. Maybe not. Well, you did the G minor. You did the G minor yesterday. What am I talking about?
Oh, did I?
Yeah. You did it yesterday in the Sinatra song that we're working on.
Oh, oh God! Now her memory's going, Chris. Oh.
In a few years.
Sorry, but you know, you only did it once. I'll give you that. You only did it once yesterday, so you probably forgot. I would have forgotten too. I get it. You know, I was just thinking, when was the last time I did it? And it occurred to me, yeah, it was a song yesterday. Yeah, I wouldn't have remembered it either if I didn't try really hard. So don't worry.
So I forgot the name of this song. I'm going to write it down so I can go to it.
Oh, 16 tons.
16 tons.
16 tons. And that is page 134 when you're going through the book. It's a good song. That's a great song. Okay. All right. Blue skies. Blue skies. Nothing but blue skies. This is a tough one. There's some weird chords in this one. Never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw a thing. Yeah, I remember. Okay. Irving Berlin, 1926. Good Lord. Okay, so what do we got in here? G7's normal. A minor's normal. C plus, which means C. Does anyone remember what that means? I kind of look like Nancy was sort of saying the word.
Augmented.
There you go. Herb,
that's
got
what
it.
I was going to say, and I went, is it augmented? Because that just seemed like it was like right there. It was right at the tip of my tongue. And I went, I shouldn't know this, but I did.
You got it. So. You got it. It's augmented. Yeah. C augmented, but they use a plus in this case. And the opposite of augmented is diminished. And you won't see a minus because a minus means minor. If you ever see a chord that says C minus, it means C minor or, you know, whatever the letter is. but what they will use is a degree symbol, like, you know, the 45 degrees, the little circle, or outside today, 2 degrees, you know. So you'll see that, and that's diminished, which is the opposite of augmented in theory, but, you know, whatever. Okay, so the B7th is just like an E minor, only your fingers go up one string each towards the ceiling, not a fret towards the ceiling. You got C, which is normal, and C augmented is a C. You play the C with your third finger, and then you reach back to the first fret, fourth string, with your first finger. E7th, hopefully you know. We just went over an E minor. It's that B7th, but moved down one string each. And this F minor is a weird one. Yeah, I'm not even sure what to compare that to, honestly. That's a tough one. First and second finger I have on the first fret, fourth and second string respectively. And then I'm reaching over to the third fret with my pinky, like so. You probably can't see that because I'm sharing, but yeah, it's very small. Let me show you, stop sharing. So like that. It's a bit of a stretch. It's not the easiest chord in the universe. But you could do it. I have faith in all of you.
Well, that chord is actually easy to put the ring finger down also behind the pinky.
The ring finger down behind, oh, to like brace it?
Well, at least you don't have to lift it up.
Yeah.
So it's a bit more pressure down, I think.
Yeah. The ring finger, what, on the second fret behind the pinky?
Yeah.
Yeah, that could work. Yeah, to kind of give you a little more. I see.
Because
that.
If you lift up your ring finger, your pinky gets a little weaker.
Yeah, it does. So put down your ring finger and your pinky is what Herb is saying, because it helps you push down with your pinky that way. And that is true. And anything behind the pinky doesn't count, because anything you play behind a finger that's down isn't going to make any difference, right? Because the chord only vibrates from the finger forward, right? So here we go. Blue skies smiling at me. Down, up, down, down, up. One, two, three, four. Blue skies shining at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Nothing but bluebirds all day long. I never saw the sun shining so bright. Never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by. When you're in love, my love, if I blue skies, all of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on. Smiling at me. To C is a little harder than it looks, a little harder than it actually is, and I'll tell you why. If you play the C with your pinky, right, which I know is a little tough for some of you, but like Herb said, you could brace it with your second, your third finger, your ring finger on the second fret. But then playing the F minor and the C, you're only putting down and picking up your first and second finger. So you could do it pretty fast. You know, you're only putting down two fingers and picking them up, basically, as long as you have your pinky on the C string, well, the C note on the first string, third fret. Alrighty, moving along. And if any one of these songs, again, I'm gonna keep mentioning this, if any one of these songs is difficult for you, write it down and come on Monday. And I would be glad to go through one of these songs step by step by step in the most complete way I possibly can. That's what the Monday class is for, between 4 and 5. Come on down. Check it out. It'll be all good.
So, Chris, I just wanted to, you know, let anybody else know who has, when they have a difficult song that they're playing. When I'm alone and I'm playing a song, I take my time and I'll actually go very slow and I'll just follow the song along and just do every chord nice and slow. And I do it a couple of times and then I try to speed it up a little bit more each time that I do it. And it just makes it easier. That's just my 2 cents.
What Nancy just said is the secret to learning music, period. I mean, that's what it is. And maybe I don't say that enough, but you play it just ridiculously slow when you're trying to learn it. Slow enough that you could actually make the changes, right? And make them in time. So what happens is your body starts to get used to when those changes are supposed to happen in the rhythm, where your fingers are supposed to go, right? And you start to get muscle memory. Then you speed it up just a little bit, and you speed it up just a little bit every single time you play it next, right? And by the time you get to the full speed of the song, you'll be a master at it, truly. That's the thing. That's how I learn really complicated pieces on guitar. That's how concert violinists learn their a particularly difficult passage. You'll see them play it really, really slowly first. Because the thing is, if you try to play it at speed in the beginning, you're going to make a lot of mistakes, and then you're going to end up learning those mistakes. You're going to get muscle memory for the mistakes, right? And then later on, you'll have to basically unlearn that muscle memory to kind of learn the song properly. So it could actually be relatively dangerous for you learning the song by playing it too fast in the beginning without actually knowing how to play it. So I mean, dangerous is the wrong word, but I meant, you know, for the song, for the music. You know what I'm saying? There you go. Thanks, Nancy. I appreciate the thumbs up. Can't buy me love. All right. Can't buy me love. The Beatles wrote so many songs that they basically contradict each other. because they wrote, I need money, that's what I want, that's what I want, that's what I want, that's what I want. That's all about, I want money, right? And then this song is about, no, money doesn't do it, man. You know, I've got all this money and diamond rings and all this stuff, but I can't buy you. So I don't, money's worthless to me. It's just really funny how they have a whole bunch of songs that sort of contradict each other just because they wrote so many. I mean, the Beatles alone wrote 200, something like 220 songs. And it's crazy how many songs they actually wrote. All right. Lennon and McCartney. This is the Island Strum. And the first chord is you just hit it once and count to, you know, four. But I'll start it. You'll see what I mean. One, two, three, four. Can't buy me love. Okay. The next song, Fade Into You. This is by a band called Mazzy Star that was really, really popular in the 90s. I mean, they were around in the 80s, but they got really hugely popular in the 90s with this song in particular, Fade Into You, which is a very slow song. I'm sure very few of you have heard it. But I love this song. And if you get a chance to listen to it, the lead singer is named Hope Sandoval. I'm not really sure which one is correct. I've heard it both ways. And it's her singing voice is so good. It's so good. Like if you listen to it while you're trying to, she'll just like sing you to sleep in a good way. You know what I mean? Like, it's just such a hypnotic, awesome song. Really good stuff. So we'll play it together. Just follow along. I know you may not have heard it before, but It goes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2. Oof, tough already. A, E, B minor is pretty much the entire song. It's going to repeat that over and over again, right? So you've got the A chord, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then what I do is I slide up to the fourth fret and bar the second, third, and fourth string for the E. And you could even reach over with your pinky to the seventh fret, first string. Then the B minor. I take that bar on the fourth fret, slide it down to the second fret, and reach over with my third finger, fourth fret, fourth string. It's a little complicated, I know, but we'll get it. We'll work together and we'll make it. And the whole thing is down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. And you see how it says swing? That's because it's sort of a down, do 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 boom, da 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 down, da 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 down. Like it's swung. When you swing something, it's a rhythmic thing. Like it's still on the beat, but it's a little bit behind the beat. So it's what makes something feel like really groovy, kind of like it gives something groove, right? I'll look up exactly how to explain swing one of these days, because I don't really know. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
A stranger's heart without a home.
to change you now. Yep, Mazzy Star. Crazy. In the 90s, lyrics didn't have to make sense. As a matter of fact, the less sense that they made, the better. That was 90s music for you, man. Look at Nirvana, Pearl. I mean, it made absolutely no sense. But they were incredibly popular. This song in particular, it's really hard to figure out what she's talking about. And it's four chords that are repeated over and over and over again. And it was huge, gigantic. This song was massive in the 90s. It was in like 50 movies, played on the radio all the time. I know nobody's heard it before, but all you skipped the 90s. What's that?
I don't like the chords.
It's hard to play. I know. It's a lot easier on guitar, and that was how they played it originally.
Yeah,
they're not the most talented musicians on the face of the earth. That's why there's only four chords repeated over and over in the song. Might be the only four he knows. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm with you, Jane. That E chord is like, I'm playing horrible.
I know.
I think the squirrels are putting their little paws over their ears because it's terrible on my end.
Hey, listen, I get it. The E chord is one of the harder chords on ukulele, for sure.
Thank you for your support, Nancy.
That's probably the worst song I've ever. I didn't play it because I.
The hardest one, yeah, it's hard.
Yeah. It is the hardest one.
That was very hard. I know. And it's the same four difficult chords over and over and over again. But again,
it can put you to sleep.
It can put you to sleep. I told you, it's a very relaxing, very, if you listen to the original too, it's hypnotic. That's the way that I kind of hear it, you know? 9 to 5, Dolly Parton. Is that at the bottom? Or at the top? That's probably the bottom. Is it an N? No.
No, it's song number 298.
Oh, it's in there? I didn't know that. I forgot that, because I probably did know it at some point. 298. Gotta be a better way than this. There it is. Stumble out of bed and I stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition. Yep, I remember this. Whole movie made out of this. That was pretty good, actually. Dolly Parton, not a bad actress.
Actor, she wrote it while she was working on the movie.
Oh, really?
Yes.
The song was created during the...
Yes.
Oh, that's cool. That's really interesting. Yeah, that was a great move. And this song was a big hit too. And for her to just sort of like write a toss-off kind of song when she was working on the movie, you know, she couldn't have put all of her effort into this song, and yet it's amazing. That's pretty impressive. It just speaks to her talent. I love Dolly Parton so much, which is weird, right? You wouldn't think it by looking at me, but
she's written some great stuff that she knows she can't sing them, that it won't do it justice.
Right. So she hands them off to other people. Like, I Will Always Love You.
Whitney Houston. Oh my God.
Yeah. Yeah. Imagine if she hadn't have given that to Whitney Houston, we would be missing one of the greatest vocal performances in history ever.
Whitney blew that out of the water. She just took that.
Oh my God.
That
note, when it finally peaks, you know, is like, how do you even do that? How do you even hit that note and hold it for like a half hour? It's just amazing. Amazing. Now, I will say this, Dolly Parton's version wasn't bad by any stretch of the imagination. It was pretty good, actually. But Whitney Houston.
It's epic.
Yeah, epic. That's, you know. How do you even compete with that? That's like her her national anthem that she did. You know, that's another one that's like, how do you even come close to that ever again? You know? So, yeah.
Hi, man. Baby.
Whitney Houston.
If you go over that, is it a B7?
It's a B flat. Let's go over that chord. So B flat. Basically what you're doing is you're barring the first and second string. I know. You can for this one, but it's harder in my opinion than barring it. You could play the first and second string with your first and second finger, but then you have to reach over with your third finger and your pinky to play the other two notes, right? So you can play it with two fingers. It is possible, but I would prefer you use the bar, and I think it makes it easier if you use the bar.
If I use the bar, I use any other fingers.
I know Dee, you're having trouble with the bar and all that stuff, but you'll get it. I'm telling you, you'll get it. And songs like this are gonna help, you know? It feels like it's never gonna happen when you're working on these songs. Like you're like, when you're playing a bar chord and you're getting the sounds you're getting out of that ukulele, you're like, this is never, ever gonna work, never. And I've had that thought with every single instrument that I've ever had to learn, except the ukulele, weirdly enough, because it's so closely related to a guitar that I kind of transition pretty easily, you know, because it's almost the same thing. It feels very much the same. All right, let's give this a try. This one's all just down ups. If you want to play along with the original, you have to capo it on the first fret. Thank you, Herb, for that information. It's awesome that we have that. And all right, here we go. I'm gonna mute up you guys here. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Stumble out of bed and I stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the street, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve a fair promotion. Want to move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. They left their dream just to watch them shatter. You might step on the boss man's ladder, but you got dreams he'll never take away. Ah, sorry. But you're in the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day a ship will come in and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and they never get you credit. You is enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, they got you where they want you. There's a better life. And you think about it, don't you? It's a rich man's game, no matter what they call it. And you spend your life putting money in his pocket. 9 to 5, oh, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. Enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, they got you where they want. That's a great song, man. Great song. And a good movie. You know what else is a good movie, but kind of saddish? Is Steel Magnolias. That's what that's one that Dolly Parton was in. I like that song. All right.
Stuck I loved her in it.
What was that?
I loved her in it.
Yeah, she was great in that movie. She really was. The super supportive, happy, yeah, you know, hairdresser.
Always saying there's a story there.
That's right. So good. Stuck in the Middle with You. This one, I believe, is in the pipeline.
No, that's 276.
Look at me go. All right. It's 276. That's way back. How do I not know that one? It's not numbered here. You know what, Vicky? I know you're watching this. You're making me look bad. There's no numbers next to these. I'm kidding, by the way. You know I'm kidding. Vicky, don't take that. She's going to take that the wrong way and like look up all the numbers and don't have to do that. It's fine. 276 or 8. We'll see. One of those two.
We have her. We don't need numbers.
276. What's that? Oh, we have Herb.
Yeah, we don't need numbers.
That is true. Herb is pretty amazing. Very amazing. So glad we have you, Herb. All right. I think, yeah, this will probably be our final song. This is all down ups. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. A7, C, D, G, and G7. I don't know why I came here tonight. Okay. One, two, one, two, three, four. Two, three, four, please. right, stuck in the middle. Yeah, man.
That was great.
Awesome.
All right.
Great song. We could probably squeeze in one more if you guys want to.
Ooh, Uptown Girl.
Yeah, we could do Uptown Girl. Now, Uptown Girl is in the pipeline, right? All right. Hey. Look, I nailed it. Finally. Because I don't remember playing that one at all. So let's go take a look.
All right.
And when she done.
Lucky for you, my dance card is empty right now. I got nothing. So well, I'm here.
I'm glad to have you here. Glad to have you here. It's only, I mean, we got 2 or 3 minutes long, and this song's only a couple minutes. Uptown Girl, right there. Uptown Girl.
Was never easy.
This is not going to be easy. And you know why?
It's Billy Joel.
It's Billy Joel, and it's a piano song. It's a piano song. So any song written on a piano tends to be slightly more difficult for a stringed instrument. But this doesn't look impossible. The fabled G minor is back in this one, as well as the A. E minor. Now the F sharp minor we haven't seen in a while. And all that is a G seventh chord moved up one string towards the ceiling. If you see it that way. Now a C minor is also in here, and that's barring the first, second, and third string on the third fret. You could also play it with three fingers if you want. Third fret, first string, second, and third. Alrighty. Let's give it a try. And one, two, one. Oh, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up.